And Jacinda Ardern's promise to help Tokelau build the political structures it needs for independence. The tiny nation's been under New Zealand governance for 94 years, and the ties are still strong. Lisa Davies is in Tokelau.
A spontaneous moment as a tafu farewelled the Prime Minister last night. There was absolute delight that she joined them on the dance floor. But this morning it was the children of Nuku Nonu's turn. They've practised for weeks for this moment. Determined to impress the New Zealand Prime Minister on her visit to their school, even singing her a very special, if belated, birthday song. In return, they delighted in getting to check out the HMNZS Otago's helicopter. Sharing in all of these moments, the Prime Minister's father, the administrator of Tokelau.
If you have any complaints about him, please come and tell me.
It's a special occasion when your daughter's the Prime Minister and you get to accompany her.
They both share the same goal, to enable Tokelau to strengthen its own governance so that it will be ready one day for independence. The United Nations wants that too, but Tokelau's already voted against going it alone.
I think it is timely to keep checking in with the people of Tokelau and ask them, is this the kind of relationship you want? Would you like that greater freedom that comes from not being a territory?
Each atoll, although part of the same tiny nation, has differing views.
We don't have export to rely on, so yeah, we're still relying to New Zealand.
Of course, yes. Tokelau want to be independent very much.
But the way they've welcomed our Prime Minister shows the links are still strong.
Is there competition between the atolls?
I would say yes, how to show up our happiness.
And that's exactly what Nuku Nonu did. As the Prime Minister came to shore this morning. Tomorrow it's on to Whakaofo. The other two atolls have certainly set the bar high. Lisa Davies, One News, Tokelau.